Ladies and gentlemen, as I informed you all that our topic of the next session is going to be consumer listening equals brand learning, and our speaker is going to be Mr. Amit Tiwari. He's the VP Marketing Havells India. Amit is a marketing professional with over 16 years of experience. During this period, he has built and expanded multi-million dollar businesses for leading global and Indian brands such as Havells, Philips, Hero Honda, Nestle, ITC, etc. So now that you're here, I'm going to give it over to you and please proceed. Thank you so much.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much, Anurag, Naval, Jyotsna, for giving me an opportunity to come and share my thoughts this evening. Really delighted to be a part of the session. And I'll tell you one, consumer listening or my particular experiences. Normally, we as speakers doesn't come on time, just come before their particular session. Today, fortunately, unfortunately, I came around 2 hours back, and it actually helped me because most of the people that I've talked about or the sessions that have actually gone helped me to build my particular presentation or my thoughts very, very well. So I think one learning what I can take is it's always better to be come 2 or 3 sessions before. That helps you to narrate your thoughts much better. And I'll tell you, this is not exactly a presentation which talks about what theories, what principles, but it is actually what I have seen and what I have followed in last more than a decade is listening. There can be different acronyms, synonyms, and metaphors for what consumer learning, listening, and all. But the fact of the matter is, before marketers, before digital, before anything, we all are consumers first. And that is the big key insight. If we are getting into the shoes of marketer or a digital marketer or XYZ, the fact of the matter is, you can't move out from your consumer shoes. And I'll tell you why I'm telling you how it actually relates to the entire fact that I'm trying to do. Can you just show the first slide, please? Next. That's it. So if you actually see and if you read those particular basic numbers, it talks about an industry which most of us, if not all of us, are related to it. And most of us can actually be related because it's a day-to-day situation and we are all part of this industry and brand. Any guesses, any thoughts? The settlement or the people who are actually satisfied is 25%. And I'm telling you, the clue is it is, we all are part of it. Directly or indirectly, mostly 95 to 98% directly, but evolved into what we actually talk about and what exactly the slide says. And that's where the basic start of listening, and that's where the birth of listening starts. And it's, can you go to the next, can you just tap the next one, please? Next tab. It is basically an industry of marriage. And why I call it an industry of marriage, if you just go through the numbers and if you go through what, the next video, please, the slide. If you go through the numbers, 75% unsatisfied customers, 50% leave after 1 year. Leave means not leave after relationship, but they really decided this is their fate and this is how they need to look for it. 25 people are settled and think that this is how we are actually look for. And what happens at the last? It breaks. It not breaks into a relationship because we are not in US or in Europe, the relationship breaks. But the fact is, we get out of the relationship because like majburiyat, we have to be in the part of the relationship. The start of this entire incident is, it's all about listening. Because we are very selective listeners as individuals. We only listen to respond. We don't listen to actually absorb. So when we don't do it in our particular relationship, there is far-fetched thing in terms of talking about as a customer, as a consumer, as a marketer is a far, far, far-fetched thing. We are not ready to listen as in a relationship which we have invested are by choice or by default. So rest all is something which is a very, very, very far-fetched thing to do because that is a forced thing to do. That's the point which I'm trying to make it. I was very curiously thinking about most of the panelists who talked about is content is consumed, it is loved by people, it is generated, user-generated content, very good, absolutely. And consumer really want to see a user-generated content, a brand content which actually comes from the brand side, which actually makes meaningful difference to their lives. And that is what it actually matters today. Irrespective, are you doing a subtle marketing? Are you trying to do a forced selling? That doesn't make any sense at all. Can you just play the first video? Mm-hmm. Observation, and I actually talk about in terms of that's what my particular topic of discussion today or sharing thoughts is. Listening is actually equal to learning, and I'll tell you why. I've been listening, and the third or the fourth session which I listened today is we have a lot of B2B customers, we have a lot of B2C customers, B2G customers, C2C customers, every type of acronyms and jargons. But the fact of the matter is there is none of this exists today, and I'm telling you that's the fact, none of them exist today. Why? Because our relationship starts from P2P, which is people to people. Rest all is immaterial. If you're not able to connect to your customers to your particular heart, then irrespective you are B2B or B2G, you'll never be able to succeed in life. That's the fundamental fact. And how it actually comes, because you have to relate to those particular people, not only by giving a definition which XYZ agency has parted, and clients have endorsed that this is what my definition is. You can also present in your boardrooms. It sounds very good because it has a jargon factor in it. That will not give it, because consumers are much more smarter and they really need to partner you. If you actually talk about how does it actually translate in our scheme of things, and I'll tell you a lot of practical examples from here. We are one of the largest fan manufacturer and seller in India, which is the Havells fan that we talk about. And we do a lot of consumer listening sessions every day. I'll take you through one of our initiatives, which is Havells Consumer Passport. What we do is we go to consumer homes, we ask them, what exactly do you look for a product, to actually bridge a need gap analysis. So one of the consumers says, and they were in, let's say, a place like in Meerut and Nazibabad. Most of the people will not even know what it is because we are a metro-centric phenomena. We sit in Delhi and we sit in Gurgaon in our offices and decide the future of India. So when we decide in that particular fact, this particular woman told me, you may be very happy, and you may be very happy to understand that you are giving 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 knobs in a fan. I don't care about it. I need a remote, because jab raat ko 2 baje thand lagti na to uthke koi neend kharab karke band nahi karna chahta. So aapne wo to kabhi socha nahi. Aap low pe rakho, high pe rakho, medium pe rakho, meri life mein koi fark nahi padta. The only difference that is make is how you are making a convenience for it. Immediately in 6 months we realize that that's a big consumer need that we are actually ignoring. And consumer is only telling us ki this is what we want. I don't want to get up 2 o'clock in the night when the AC is there. I don't want to switch off the AC because that is required. Why can't you provide a remote? Home decorative lighting is one of the facts. When people said, I can't change my light, 10 lights in one room is not possible. Today I have a romantic mood, I can have a romantic light. That's only as a click of a button. I don't need to have, why do you need to have 5 different channels? Why can't it have been done by one particular click of a sword and I can get an aura of what exactly is the evening light? So the amount of intrinsic values that we actually get from what you need to do, from what a consumer talks about, is all about careful listening, not selective listening. All marketers, including me, since I'm keeping the hand to the heart, I'm also representing marketing as a function and also representing marketers here on this particular platform. We all have a habit of selective listening. And that starts, I've just built the narration, we do it in our personal lives. How can we just change our clothes, go to office, and we change our narrative of behavior, what we're doing it entire 14 hours in our house? Practically impossible. It does not happen, it will not happen. So the charity begins at home. If you don't think as a person, you start listening, then all discussions, all debates about that we should talk about customers, we should listen about, doesn't work in that scenario at all. Can you move to the next slide, please? Also about when you talk about listen, please, as a marketer, as a function, consumers are visual learners. Because if you see, you can't compare the literacy rate across India that people will understand what you talk about, what you really need to talk about. Everybody, and I've been following this and that, glad at least I'm able to comprehend that, everybody will tell what to do, but nobody will tell how to do. That's the fundamental challenge today. You will have 10 different ideas, what you need to do for the brand, what you need to do for the product. But how do you need to do? That only will come from a consumer, because he knows exactly what is the touch point that he would be satisfied with that particular base. And that is what we need to have. What is the need and how are you fulfilling that particular need? Can you move to the next slide, please? I think the data is missing. And this is a hard-coded fact data. We only listen. It is just about being defensive when you are actually treating as a customer. And I'll tell you, I have listened to a lot of customer care calls in my particular organization, my previous avatars and all. 50 to 60% of the time, we only try to be defensive and give an answer for a reason that we will solve your complaint. But the bigger and the larger question is, why did the need for a complaint exist? Why it can't be solved before? And if you're only there to solve a particular challenge, which is primarily a complaint, then you are leaving your customer again unsatisfied. Why you are leaving unsatisfied is because you are not fulfilling what exactly he wants. Today I have a temporary problem, you have solved it. But the root cause of the problem, we never identify, we never go into it, because we are not bothered. My job, a customer care executive will say, I have responded to this particular query, and from the lot of IT industry, we have got a jargon called TAT. Sir, 3 minutes, TAT has been fulfilled, and now it's up to you. When you have, no customer is interested in TAT, and no customer is interested in how you're actually, he's only interested in one thing. Will this organization thinks about me? Will this organization think, they don't interact with customer care, they don't interact with marketing, they interact with brand. And we fail then and there itself, because we are only trying to fulfill, as a defensive person in life, that we are trying to solve the complaint that we have. But why does the complaint exist? And most of the organization, the saddest part of the story, we talk in most of the organization, most of the events today happens about social media listening is happening, listening is moving on. But most of the brands don't even respond on social media, even on different platforms which are not there. Okay, you may be responding to people on your LinkedIn page or your Facebook page, but what about other comparative sites? Let's say Naptol, let's say other particular comparative sites, what happens to that? No, that's not my domain, somebody else would have put it. But you're losing a prospective customer. He's going and ranting about yourself, ranting about your brand, about your category. Who is going to talk about that? No, that's not my domain. He must be a customer who is notorious by nature. Why will a customer be notorious for your brand? That's the time anybody has. We are in a society of money rich and time poor. Do we really have time to actually talk about those things? But we try to think it's fine. Till the time it's not becoming a big problem, let's try and bury how we can actually move from there. Now we'll actually move, can you just move to the next slide, please? And this is what a basic framework which I follow and I've been following and firmly believe, which is everything has to start from a consumer decision journey. Rest all will fall in place if your platform is absolutely right. And your platform has to be absolutely, absolutely right. You need to know what is the decision journey your consumer will follow. If that is done by category, by product, and by brand, then the entire challenge of what is the need of a customer is understood at one go. Can you just play the video, please? slide, please. So this is the framework we actually follow, and in Havells we operate around 30 plus categories. Every category, it's mandatory to have a consumer decision journey framework, which tells us right from a trigger stage till the final post-purchase, how does the entire consumer pattern moves? And how do we need to understand what are the challenges in each and every bucket that actually look for? That gives you a clear picture, what is the challenge that you're trying to address? Not challenge as in whole, what is the challenge that you're actually trying to address in one particular case? The challenge can be awareness, the challenge can be familiarity, the challenge can be post-purchase, because you're not able to provide the service to that. We know exactly at what particular stage in the entire consumer decision journey makes the life much, much more simpler for a marketer and much, much more intuitive for a consumer to understand what things can actually go wrong. The point which I was talking about, that why would you need to wait for a complaint, these frameworks helps in terms of these are the probable areas of interest which consumer can actually, we can actually fail as an organization. Why can't we look for it? So I'll tell you an example specifically in very high-end fans. So consumer comes with an expectation that I want a decorative fan. Decorative fan is a very, very normal English semantic word. It can have at least 114 permutation in combination. What do you want in that? It's a color, it's a texture, is the design matching to your upholstery, is the design matching to your walls, what do you want? Sometimes what happens is, consumer comes as a very confused lot, and that's what the job of R as a sales point or as a marketers makes much more interesting is how you can convince him rather than confusing. So how you can actually convince is, this is what your color is, man, don't worry, we'll come to your particular place, somebody will come, we'll tell you what exactly matches with four or five different options. If you want to buy from us, it's fine. If you don't buy from us, it's fine. You're actually winning that customer. Irrespective, they may not buy from you, but they will always, always have a very positive rub off on your, these guys are thorough professionals, they understand the need of a consumer. And that helps in a lot of different tangents that need to look for. Most of the, in today's lighting as a profession, most of the consumer comes and ask about, do you really have a soft light or it is only a marketing gimmick? Nobody has an idea. A light is a light, a bulb is a bulb is a bulb. You can't provide, we'll provide a light. It all depends upon what's the lux level that you actually provide, how many block points that you have in your house, and all that dimension depends whether the light will be soft or hard on your particular. You have to give an extra step and say, we will come to your place, we will give you a lux level measurement, then we'll tell you whether you need a 3 light or whether you need 2 light or whether you 1 light, and then can actually give you a dimension of what we need to do. Whether you buy from us is perfectly fine, whether you don't buy from us is perfectly fine. But we're trying to make an inroad into the consumer's house. We move to the next slide, please. So this is a passport program. This is basically Havells Consumer Passport Program, which we have initiated around 3 months back as a pilot. Now we are rolling it in a very, very big way. I'll show you a video which is actual consumers. So we go to actual consumers, we reach out to actual consumers, speak to them, and this interaction is pre-appointed. So we have a research agency who helps us in terms of getting the appointments. And what we do is, in this particular framework is, from a 45 minutes to a 3 hours, depending upon how interesting a consumer wants to get into this particular interaction, talks about everything without even mentioning that we are from Havells or XYZ brand. So we are doing the entire phenomena says we are a company which we want to do research and understand what consumer behavior and pattern is. Depending upon your time, we want to know exactly how to. And it is mandatory for everybody and anybody in the marketing organization of Havells, right from a management trainee to the head of the department, has to go and has to be a part of this entire program. And why we call it a passport program, in the next slide I'll show it to you, which is, there's a passport, and every quarter, at least 3 visits are mandatory, and it has to be signed and stamped by that research agency. From coming years, we are also trying to make it as a part of the PPM as an appraisal process. If it has not been followed, your 5% of weightage will not go from there. The entire idea of doing that is enforcing is to get the best out of a consumer insight. You can have a repository of people who can actually talk about. And when I'll play this video, you'll understand people really talk and consumer really want to talk about what they actually feel and what are their experiences across. Can you just play the video, please?
Fans,
these are Havells.
Havells. So I've got experience of using Crompton, Usha.
Havells, as a brand, the way they have created themselves,
think trust factor is also coming up. Devils is number one for me. Crompton probably would be number two.
Fusha is there, Bajaj is there, Havels is there. The first in your mind goes that, okay, it should be Havels.
I think there was noise that started coming in the fan. Plus, jo uska overall speed tha, usme kuch, you know, it was not giving me that. Kind of it, agar usko fan ko chala raha hu aur uspe jitna usko air fankna chahiye, I was not getting that. They said, ye jo design hai, kuch us tarikhe ka jo unique design tha, they said, this bus will not get accommodated. And that's a problem. Five pe leha tha na speed ko, so it started irritating me.
पर्पस क्या है कि हवा अच्छी आनी चाहिए, अदरवाइज रिमोट कंट्रोल इज अगेन गुड. जैसे प्राइस का इशू नहीं है, प्राइस का इशू मैं नहीं समझता कि प्राइस की 5000 5500 6000 रुपए से मतलब डिफरेंस. मेरा मानना है कि यदि फैन शुरुआत में स्ट्रॉन्ग बिल्ड या बॉल बेयरिंग वगैरह है वो इंपॉर्टेंट है आपके, और 5-7 साल तो ऐसा इशू होना नहीं.
तो ब्लेड्स में आप देखोगे तो वो ऐसे होने की वजह से 10 उतना नहीं कमोडेट होता है. तो पहले वाले हमारे फैंस के जो ब्लेड्स थे वो थोड़ा यू करके होते थे.
अच्छा,
स्पीड यूज टू easily do, I mean, there should be some concrete and evident stuff that goes, if your air is dirty as 100, by using this fan, you will probably be able to clean it 60. Okay. If till that level you people go, so important things are, what our product look like, durability, I feel should be at least 5 to 6 years.
Simple and sober. That's our prime.
So just doesn't accumulate on the fins.
Next slide, please. So this is the passport I was talking about. This is actually in the form of a passport. The idea of name of passport is to get an entry into a consumer home, to get into a people to understand, and you will also have a recall. So there's on one particular page you can write and you can document all the insights that you're actually generated during your entire interaction with the consumer. So that when you go to the next time, you know this is what the questions that I've asked, what is the next set of questions that I need to look for, and what are the new insights that I can talk about. If you, I know the quality of the video is not that great, but if you actually see the major insights that are actually talked about, consumer can also tell you how do you need to design your product, how do the product planning needs to come into the place, because they are the actual users. They can act, we may talk about a lot of jargons that 200 RPM is the best airflow that comes, but if in my room the entire particular airflow is not there, it doesn't make any sense irrespective of whatever technical jargons that you need to provide. And these are the guys who are actually your custodians for the product and for the brand. If you're able to satisfy from what they tell, and you are able to get the knowledge that you can actually transfer, that can actually devise your product and your product services much better. Can you move to the next slide, please? If you actually see, that's what I believe in this. There are very few fundamentals. There is no larger or no bigger picture that actually talks in the entire thing. Is try to be relevant to any consumer that to be. When I say relevant, it's not about being very honest. It's about what you can do and how much time you can do. If you can commit, it will take 3 hours to do it, please say it will take 4 hours and then do it in 3 hours rather than saying it 2 hours and delivering in 5 days. You will always have a very, very detractor as a customer. He will never believe you. And that's where your entire trust factor goes. It takes ages and ages and decades to build a trust. With one interaction, the trust grows for a toast. Be reliable. That you can actually be at whatever point that you need to be. There are many services industry where people believe only on reliability, and reliability is the barometer for that particular industry. Be at least reliable for anyone you're actually interacting to. Be responsive, as I just mentioned. There is no, in a consumer mindset, there is no tact, there is no time in terms of that you need to look. Be responsive doesn't make that, oh, you have sent, thank you so much, we'll get back to you and somebody from our office will get back to you. Nobody is bothered about that. People are only interested in how much time my problem is solved, and try to be as authentic it can be. And the last but not the least in this particular framework is be convenient. When I say convenient is, I'll tell you a case from a previous organization in Philips. There was a lady, she used to stay in Janakpuri, and there was no center in terms of for getting a small domestic appliances repaired. She was 83 years old lady. For good 20 days, she was trying to get her steam iron corrected. The plate was actually burnt and she was not able to go because she was quite old. She doesn't know where the call center was and how the service center can. Service center guys was, area mein log nahi jate, we can't come, we'll let you know somebody else with service. So Janakpuri will be served by Dwarka or Dwarka. And this problem within the organization, within the service center, was not solved for good 20 days. This lady just called to our particular office on reception And by chance, there was somebody as a senior at the reception said, what's the call? Just give it to me. Just find out what it is. So there's a plate problem. Don't worry, ma'am. Just took the address. Within 3 hours, the plate was removed, told, and we sent a proper note, which is sorry from the MD, that really from your age and all, it is extremely sorry and disappointing that we could not solve it. Make sure, please call on our particular board line numbers if you have any challenges, and we will get you things done. So at the convenient, that particular woman, she was not very savvy in terms of, she just wrote an SMS to one of the service executives that really gives me a pleasure to work with an organization like this. So you are not trying to solve things only through a call center, but you are trying to make him convenient what he or she needs. And that is what the basic idea of getting and winning a particular consumer and listening what their particular needs is. Can you move to the next slide, please? If you actually see, and this is what my understanding and my particular thoughts on various learning across the spectrum is, and I personally believe that's what we need to deliver in our particular behavior when we do, when we interact with them. We actually have a genuine interaction, not only a fabricated interaction. Most of the call centers, and without barring thing, people will give you a fabricated answer or a basically answer that this will happen, this is going to happen, I'm making you to speak to a supervisor. Nobody's interested in your supervisor, and nobody's interested in who is my problem being solved by the people who are actually looked for. Be genuine, and consumer respect and value genuinity of any particular organization or a brand that actually talk about. And please always don't treat them that you are, okay, if one consumer is unhappy, it's fine. One consumer can actually spoil a lot of other consumers because the word of mouth, negative word of mouth, it multiplies to 11x then to a positive word of mouth. And tell them the reality. Nobody is telling you that they will be actually, but tell them a reality. The fact is, because we don't want to take the acceptability of what we want to do, we always try to give him a make the consumer in a false paradigm. And consumer is not fool. Because when you're actually interacting with 7 or 8 or 10 different propositions or then different organizations, they know who can actually be a best way to look for. Always, the best time and always to win a customer, always to talk about consumer listening, is always the first place, please follow up. At one time, nothing happens. But if you follow up, it will show your interest. It will show how much you can care for him, how much it can actually work in the entire particular ecosystem that you're talking about. They will always make at least 4 or 5 comments about your as a brand that this is what you need to build. That the consumer will think that this organization really cares for me. And that can actually multiply a lot of factors in the entire thing. Most important in the entire 7 or 8 secrets, there's no secret, this is very common sense, and that we need to follow. It's all about how do we actually inculcate in our behaviors is respect, respect, and respect your customer. It may be any customer, any particular, but he or she is an individual first. Again, the principle of it's P2P, it's people to people, start having the respect. If somebody is calling you 5 times on a call center, if somebody is calling you for 4 times for the same particular product thing, you have no right, if you're in the business, to get irritated. You have sold it, you have made that particular service to that, and it's this 100% responsibility of that particular individual to reach out to you. So please respect the entire thing. And I personally believe, and that's what my mantra, which I think is, customer first, leave for the rest. If your customer is in, then rest can all happen. That's what I have to deliver. Thank you so much.